In this video, we'll learn how to make two-dimensional transformations in p5js using the translate, rotate, and scale functions. I've got an example file here that I'll link to in the description. So by default in p5, our coordinate system starts in the upper left corner. So that's where our origin is, our 0, 0 point. And anytime we're drawing shapes with functions like rect or ellipse or text, we're placing those on the canvas relative to that origin. So one way to move shapes around is to simply change the numbers that we're assigning when we place those on our canvas. Now, a different way to move things side to side or up or down is by using the translate function. So let's go ahead and use a translate function right here on line 12. So I'm just going to type in translate, and then inside those parentheses, I'll type in an X value and a Y value to tell P5 how far to move things horizontally and vertically. So let's make this 180, 180. Notice what happens when we insert that translate function. All of our shapes have moved 180 pixels horizontally and 180 pixels vertically. And we can see by where our grid image is placed on the screen, what's happened to our coordinate system. So the translate function moves the entire coordinate system based on the numbers that we're putting in for our arguments. And notice that for all these other shape calls, I haven't changed the coordinate arguments, but they've still changed place on screen because I've translated the entire coordinate system. Translate can be really useful in interactive or motion-based sketches. And it's also really useful when put into combination with some of our other transform functions like rotate and scale. So let's take a look at rotate. And here I'm just going to replace my line that has translate, and we'll make that rotate instead. So I'm going to write out my rotate function and then type in 0.5. So the way the rotate transformation function works is by spinning the coordinate system at the origin. So you can see we've rotated everything on screen, and it's kind of hinging on that upper left point, which is the origin. Now, in some cases, that's what we want, but maybe in my case, I'd like to rotate the square and not the entire coordinate system. So how do we do that? Well, we can combine a rotate call with a translate call. And essentially the technique here will be to translate our coordinate system so that the center of rotation we want is at the origin. I'm going to highlight and comment out that rotate line for now. So let's get our translate back up. We'll translate 180, 180. And the reason that I know what coordinates to use when I do my translate here is because I've already set those in my rectangle call. And here is where we need to do a little bit of moving around of the coordinates of our shape functions, because we've moved that origin here to the center, but I want the square to still be in that same place visually on screen. So I'm going to go through all my shape function calls and essentially subtract the horizontal and vertical values that I'm feeding into that translate function. So when I get to my rectangle, I'll say 180 minus 180 is 0, 180 minus 180 is 0. Same thing here for my text function. Those are both going to be 0, 0. Whoops. And then for our ellipse, 300 minus 180 is 120, 200 minus 180 is 20. Notice that now my rectangle, my text, and my ellipse visually are in the same place, but my coordinate system, which is represented by my grid image, has moved. So now when I apply my rotate, I should be able to rotate right around the center of that rectangle. So let's talk about that number argument that we feed into our rotate function call. Rotations are defined by angles, and in P5, radians are the default unit for measuring angles. And we can imagine how those angles are situated in space by looking at this graphic here on the right. So we're starting at 0 towards the right and moving clockwise around our center of rotation all the way back to 2 pi radians or 360 degrees. Now, maybe you're comfortable working in radians, and that's great. If you're not, we can really easily convert degrees to radians by wrapping those degrees in the radians function. So let's take a look at how that works. So rather than typing in 0.5, which P5 is going to assume is an angle in radians, we can type in that radians function. And let's say we want this to move 45 degrees. And just just close out our parentheses there. So really easy to play back and forth with angles and radians without having to think too hard about it. Let's go ahead and take a look at scale. So after my rotate line here, I'm just going to type out scale, and then we'll need to enter in a scaling factor. So this is a number. Let's go ahead and type in 2 here and take a look at what happens. Okay, so I can see everything is bigger on the screen. And that makes sense to me because the number that we're putting into our scale function, it's also called our scaling factor, anytime it's greater than 1, we're going to be making our coordinate system bigger. If we're putting in a number that's between 0 and 1, we'll be making things smaller. So you can see if I change this to 0.2, then things get tinier. So let's switch that back to 2. Also notice that our scaling, just like our rotations, is taking place around the origin of our coordinate system. Okay, so that's a nice quick overview of 2D transformations in p5.js using translate, rotate, and scale.